What is the Discord app? The Discord app is free and the only cross-platform voice and text chat app of its kind, designed specifically for gamers. It was created to replace other voice over internet protocol services by offering features that gamers love, particularly those obsessed with massively multiplayer online games. Discord allows users to create and join servers, channels, or chat rooms to interact with select groups of people based on something they have in common, forming a sort of tribe. Users can also send direct messages to others, so conversations are kept private. Some outside the gaming community are finding this app useful and have started using it to replace Skype or Facebook Messenger. It can be used on either desktops or phones. Other attributes of Discord is that users can access the app via their internet browser, PC, or mobile device. The app is designed for users age 13 and up to use in real time while playing games. In order to view content that is NSFW, not safe for work, users must confirm that they are 18 or older. The Discord app is in the category of social networking, which should tell you what they really emphasize: communication. As far as App Store ratings, for Apple, it is 12 plus for infrequent, mild, mature, suggestive themes, sexual content, profanity, etc. And Google Play has it for teen. What do parents need to know about Discord? It's now a massively popular app. During the pandemic, Discord exploded to over 100 million members. The app is fun for keeping groups in touch. Consider all of the different circles of friends and associates each one of us has in life. Wouldn't it be so much easier if we could connect with each directly through one simple app? For gamers who see themselves as a tribe of their own, this ability to speak with other gamers is important. Privacy and limits can be customized, but users who create servers or channels are able to limit who can join or message people within their group. The default setting, however, is no verification requirement at all. Reports of abuse have skyrocketed along with the user base. Server video. This drop-in, drop-out video chat is similar to House Party. So users select when they are open to chatting and other users can see that and join them. To learn more about the House Party app, we have it linked in the description. GIFs, emojis, and images are easy to share. The interaction with images that could be sexual in nature would stem from the user and the user's connections, which are able to be limited. Game streaming. As of August 2019, users can stream a game to up to 10 friends. The feature is called Go Live and is an extension of their video chat and screen share feature that was introduced 2 years ago. Is there pornography on Discord? There has been some buzz, which began in late March 2017, stating there were channels where child pornography was being shared. As a company, Discord stated it was investigating the issue and offered directions on how users should respond if they encountered illegal activity. There are a few obscure hidden doorways to a Google search, but a child would have to be highly motivated to find it. The problem is that any digital environment that promotes secrecy or privacy to its users is always going to have a lot of inappropriate content if you're looking for it. In this way, Discord struggles. Users intentionally create servers and groups in order to be private and at times inappropriate with each other. Nothing is moderated. Here is an App Store quote from a parent. The bottom line is Discord safe. Discord can be fun if used safely and with supervision, but it feels like a high school level app. There are always risks, especially when direct messaging options are available. This kind of app can also foster an environment of secrets if users are not cautious. If appropriate security measures are not taken when creating a chat group or the person is not discerning when joining a channel, there can be privacy risks. Conversations surrounding the reason for use and the types of chat rooms being used and accessed, as well as the types of servers your child would create, should be foundational when deciding if you let your teen use this app. To learn more about the Discord app and to read our other app reviews, just check out our website at protectyoungeyes.com.